What if I told you there's an add-on tool for Final Cut Pro that gives you almost infinite possibilities? I mean, this tool is so useful, I'm honestly surprised it's not built right into Final Cut Pro. Now, what if I told you you could easily make this tool yourself, or download it completely free from a number of places on the internet? Do I have your attention yet? The tool I'm talking about, as some of you may have guessed already, is an adjustment layer. And today, I'm going to show you my top 5 uses for adjustment layers in Final Cut Pro. First, let's briefly take a look at what an adjustment layer is. And it's really simple. An adjustment layer is a title preset that, when you initially add it above your timeline, does nothing. But any adjustments you make to this adjustment layer directly affect everything that's under it. Let me show you what you can do with it. The first and most common use for adjustment layers is applying a color grade or an effect to multiple clips. Down in my timeline, I have a mini project I want to add a color grade to. Instead of adding a color grade directly to my clips, I'll add an adjustment layer above my timeline, make sure it's selected, and apply my color grade to the adjustment layer. I'm going to make it fairly drastic for demo purposes. I'll also maybe add a film grain effect to my adjustment layer. Now, if I take this adjustment layer and ripple trim it out over my entire project, my color grade and any effects I apply to my adjustment layer are transferred over to my entire project. Much faster than doing this to every clip individually. Next use for an adjustment layer I want to talk about today is adding a letterbox effect to your project. Add an adjustment layer above your clip, press Command 5 to open the effects browser, and search for the letterbox effect. Add this effect to your adjustment layer clip, and in the inspector, select your aspect ratio for a sweet cinematic letterbox look. Now, you're probably thinking, why can't you just add this effect to your clip? Well, you can, but if you have a clip like mine, where the subject's head gets cropped off by the letterbox bars, you can't adjust the framing. Adding this effect to an adjustment layer leaves your clip unaltered, and you can still use the transform tool to reframe the clip under it. Number 3 is adding custom transitions between your clips. Using an adjustment layer above your clips allows you to take a number of built-in Final Cut Pro effects and turn them into custom transitions. Add an adjustment layer above your clips, and from the effects browser, select the effect you want to use for your transition. Add this effect to your adjustment layer. Place your playhead between your clips, and with the adjustment layer selected, in the inspector, bring the amount slider all the way up. Add a keyframe to the amount slider. Go back about 1 second, and bring the amount slider all the way down. Move your playhead about 1 second into your second clip, and once again, bring the amount slider all the way down to 0. Add a cross dissolve to your clips under the adjustment layer for your own custom transition. Use number 4 for an adjustment layer in Final Cut Pro is the picture-in-picture effect. Add the clip you want inside the picture-in-picture window above your timeline, and add an adjustment layer above it. Ripple trim the adjustment layer so it's the same length as your clip. Go to the effects browser, select the masks category, and add a shape mask to your adjustment layer. Adjust the mask shape and position it where you want your picture-in-picture window. Use the transform tool on the clip under your adjustment layer to reframe it inside the picture-in-picture window. Now, since an adjustment layer affects every clip under it, the mask was also applied to the bottom clip. To only affect a certain clip with an adjustment layer, simply make a compound clip. Select the adjustment layer clip and the clip you want inside your picture-in-picture window and combine them into a compound clip with Option G. This reveals your bottom clip for a simple picture-in-picture effect. Now, the benefit of using an adjustment layer for this is if you need to reframe or even replace a clip inside your picture-in-picture window, you don't have to start over. Just double-click on the compound clip to open it in a separate timeline and reframe or replace your clip under the adjustment layer. Press the back arrow to go back to your timeline and your new clip is placed, properly framed inside your picture-in-picture window. And, as always, I save the best for last. Before we take a look at my top use for adjustment layers in Final Cut Pro, I just want to take a few seconds to tell you about the sponsor of today's video, MotionVFX. When it comes to quality, professional plugins for Final Cut Pro, no one even compares to MotionVFX. MotionVFX has a huge selection of Final Cut Pro plugins that can help your videos stand out above the rest. They have unique titles transitions, effects, and a 3D tracker that makes a built-in object tracker in Final Cut Pro seem like it belongs in iMovie. They even have a few amazing freebies, like the M adjustment layer and the super useful M cam rig plugin. All MotionVFX plugins are thoroughly tested and their customer support is second to none. There's a reason MotionVFX is trusted by some of the biggest brands out there, including Apple, Google, Discovery Channel, NFL, and so many more. You've probably even seen some of their plugins featured in Apple keynotes, especially when they talk about Final Cut Pro. By purchasing plugins from MotionVFX through the links in my video description, you also help support this channel so I can keep making free tutorials like this one for you every week. Check out some of my favorites linked below and see how MotionVFX can help you make better videos. Now, back to Final Cut Pro. My top use for an adjustment layer in Final Cut Pro is making custom split screens. Let me show you how you can make a cool vertical three-screen split effect. Layer your three clips in the timeline and disable the top two to see your bottom clip. Add an adjustment layer above your bottom clip and add a shape mask to this adjustment layer. Resize your mask so it takes up about a third of the screen, maybe a bit less. Select your middle clip and press V to re-enable it. Grab your adjustment layer, hold down the Option key, and drag up to make a copy of it. In the video inspector, move the mask over to the left third of your frame by entering negative 1280 for position X value. Use the transform tool to reframe your clip inside this window. Repeat the same steps for your top clip. Select it, V to re-enable it, make a copy of your adjustment layer, and enter positive 1280 to move the shape mask over to the right side of your screen. Once again, use the transform tool to reframe your clip. Select each clip and the adjustment layer directly above it, and combine them into compound clips to reveal the clips below them. In just a few easy steps, you have this cool three-screen vertical split effect. There's a ton more you can do with adjustment layers. I'll leave a few links in my video description for other awesome uses for adjustment layers in Final Cut Pro. And if you don't have one yet, go to the MotionVFX website where you can download one completely free. While there, check out some of the other awesome plugins they have. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.